Is this working? I think I got it. Yay! Did I get it? Woo! Yay! Okay, I got it. Can you guys see me? Wait, people are saying that you can't see me, but can you see me? I'm telling you, kids, you stream. You guys are seeing me. Okay, hallelujah. Everybody's seeing me. So I want to thank you guys for joining me on my second Ustream that I told up to two in case the word second didn't come through clear enough. This is exciting. This is business. This is real. Brace yourselves, children. A second Ustream has come upon us. So my first one, like I told you last week that my Ustream kind of show is going to be called Stuck Being Jeanette. So my first one last week was called, I don't know, somebody want to remind me? Stuck something or other. And this one is called Stuck in My Teeth. If you want to know the relevance there, it's because I went to the dentist the other day. I have a fantastic dentist. He is one of a kind, plus his name is Dr. Diamond, which makes him extra cool, if he was not cool enough, as was. But I got my teeth cleaned, got my pearly whites cleaned. Eeps! And... Bazinga. Oh. Stuck in Traffic was the name of my last Ustream. Thank you for kindness to the person who just texted me that. So I went to the dentist and he cleaned my teeth. And it just got me thinking, oh, what if you have something stuck in your teeth? That's the worst. And then also, what is especially the worst is if you're like out to dinner and you have something stuck in your teeth, and the person that you thought was your friend who's out to dinner with you doesn't tell you that you have something stuck in your teeth. So when you go to the bathroom after you eat, you see this thing in your teeth, and then you go, how long has it been there? And why didn't anyone bring this to my attention? Chivalry is dead. It's a shame. Crying shame. Oh, thank you for your nice compliments, you guys. You guys are also sweet. Summer Seeds, I hate it. Oh, Bieberlicious, thank you. Bazinga, yeah. Your nickname at school is Pearly Whites? That's very cool. I love seeing your guys' little comments here. It's so exciting for me. I want to say thank you guys for joining me. Appreciate your kindness. I think I'm going to do a few question and answers today, and I'm also going to phone a few friends. And no, we're not on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. 50-50, can I get an audience? Cool. Also, I wanted to play you guys this song because I love it so much, and you have to tell me if you've heard of it, okay? If you've heard of Mika, start writing your comments. And this song is called Grace Kelly. I just love it. Just love it. Just makes me dance. I want to talk to you. The last time we talked, Mr. Smith, you reduced me to tears. I promise you that won't happen again. They talk in the beginning of the song. How great. Do I repulse you with my queasy smile? Am I too dirty? Am I too flirty? Do I like what you like? I could be wholesome, I could be loathsome, guess I'm a little bit shy. Why don't you like me? Why don't you like me without making me try? I try to be like Chris Kelly. Walk out the door. Oh, I love it so much, you guys. I love this song with a burning, fiery passion that has gotten me to listen to it probably, I don't know, somewhere in the 600 or 700 count over the past like 4 days. It's intense. My love for this song is real. It is a lasting love, and it is a bond shared only between two married individuals, so I might as well marry the song. Oh, I'm reading your comments. Excellent. Thank you, guys. So now I'm going to answer a few questions that I just asked you to send me through Twitter. That was Twitter. Excuse me. Can't speak too well, apparently. Let me just tell you, kids, I am a little bit sleepy. I didn't sleep too well last night. Actually went to San Luis Obispo with one Nathan Kress and one Big Time Rush. And we actually did it. We rocked a school. It's part of this campaign that Nick is doing right now called Nick Rocks Your School. Appropriate. And we just, it was like a sweepstakes, 150,000 kids entered, and one girl named Amy Boggins won. So we all visited her school in San Luis Obispo, and we just talked to all the students and played games with them. It was a really fun day, but I just couldn't fall asleep last night in the hotel because I was really sick, had fever and what have you, so I was like chilling and shaking and bringing the covers up over me more and more, and then it was just, what are you gonna do? Fevers. Can't live with them. Could live without them. Wish they didn't exist. Anything you like. Gotta be green, gotta be mean. Gotta be everything more. Okay, so you guys, here, I've favorited some of the questions that you guys were sending me so that I can answer them. And you're still sending me them so I can return back to that as well. Hey to Brazil! What's up? Okay, SPU, literal, just letter, tube, official, asks, how do you deal with stress? I don't. I'm crumbling. No, I'm kidding. Sometimes I scratch my head when I'm nervous. So that question, stress. I don't know. How do I deal with stress? I talk to my mom if I'm stressed out about things. Shout out. She's watching. Hey, mama. Hey, baby. What you know? So I don't know. I usually just talk to my mom, or I write things down all the time. I feel like writing is a very therapeutic platform for me. So I do that. And XO SETI Lover XO. Oh, they asked me to do a cover. So that isn't really a question. Cosgrove McCurdy asked, who was your inspiration to become an actress-singer? I started acting because I loved Star Wars so much, and because I basically liked people in movies better than people in real life. No offense to people in real life, they're great, as I've come to know. Especially you guys, bitabomb.com and org and net and all the other URLs out there. But I just really... I felt like I found friends in movies, and in movie characters. The end. Amazing McCurdy asked, and these are, by the way, these are the Twitter profile names, because I'm reading questions from Twitter. So I can get to some of your guys' questions on Ustream as well, but right now I'm just reading from Twitter. Amazing McCurdy, first of all, thank you for your profile picture, thank you for your name, asks, do you like it, would you like it if Melanie comes back? For those of you who don't know, Melanie was a character on iCarly that is Sam's twin. And she is very different from Sam. She's very, very sort of girly, flirty, flowery is a way I might describe her. And just sort of overall has a more, I feel like she'd get flummoxed a lot easier than Sam would, if that makes any sense. So, yeah, I mean, honestly, that was one of my favorite episodes because playing two characters was excellent. And, hey, I think I might be the only person who's ever played two characters on iCarly, which is pretty cool. But I just, I don't know, I really enjoyed doing that. It was a great experience. I thank Dan Schneider for writing it. Yeah. Happy birthday! Somebody said it was their birthday. IMOE man 83 asks, how small was that plane? If you're talking about the plane that I took today from the lovely San Luis Obispo, it was rinky dink. It was like a 30 seater. It was very nerve wracking, felt very precarious, made me feel very edgy. I was clinging to the seat, I was clinging to the stewardesses, and I was clinging to anything in sight that would prevent me from falling off. DENII_girl asks, do you have something you want to do but you have never been able to do? I mean, I feel like there's a lot of things that I want to do that I haven't done yet. And also there's a lot of things that I don't think I could necessarily say off the top of my head, I want to do such and such. But if the offer came to the surface, I might say, like, oh yeah, sure, I'll try that. I don't know. I've thought, I'm pretty adventurous, so there's probably quite a few things that I'd like to try to do that I haven't done yet. Karina underscore Jathan asked, what is your height? I'm 6'1". Thanks for asking. I was tall girl. okay. Just Jeanette asked. First of all, Just Jeanette, a special shout out to you. I thank you so much. You have the most amazing website. You guys have to check this website out. It's justjeanette.com. And this is a fan site that is so incredible. It's so up to date. It's so current. It's so full. And it's so accurate. I definitely endorse that website fully. And I thank you for making it. And I thank any of you guys who have viewed it for viewing it. So Just Jeanette, have you been shopping for Christmas already? Geez, let me try that again, since apparently I can't speak. It is a Wednesday after all. Have you been shopping for Christmas already? The answer is yes. I went shopping the other day with me mama, and we were just kind of looking around the stores. I wanted to get an idea because I have kind of one shopping day where I go to get an idea of what I want to get. Then I have another shopping day where I go back to get certain ideas, to get certain gifts for certain people. Then I have another day where I go and get more things for more people. Somebody just said, you're not 6'1", you're more like 5'1". I'm not telling which I am. I definitely didn't make an error, if that's what you were thinking. No, I meant 6'1 when I said 6'1". Hey, you guys, Nate from Ustream is calling me. Because I just called him because I didn't think I was going to be able to get it set up. But I did. But I shouldn't answer. Eeps. Somebody asked if Miranda's tall, too. Well, if I'm 6'1", I'm guessing Miranda's, about 6'2". And that would put Jerry at around 7-something. No, I could tell you my real height, but... Why? What good would that do? I'm gonna call some people now. Calling. Miranda Cosgrove, I'm calling for you. I wish you would have answered, cause then my dream would come true. But you didn't, so I'll cry tears of despair. Hey, I wish you were there to witness them. The end.